Well, the UK is blocking conservatives from visiting that country. They say conservatives could be hazardous to the nation's diversity somehow. This past weekend, American YouTube personality Brittany Pettibone and her Austrian boyfriend were barred from entering the UK because they planned to interview Tommy Robinson, an outspoken critic of Islam. Then on Monday, British police halted a visit by Canadian journalist Lauren Southern on the ground she was, quote, a radical Christian and therefore possibly a terrorist. Meanwhile, radical Muslims, more than 400 former ISIS fighters, are believed to have re-entered Britain without any problem at all. Indeed, they were welcomed. Huh? Katie Hopkins is a columnist with The Rebel. She wrote the book Rude, and she joins us now. Katie, it's great to see you. I mean, only a country that really hates itself, its heritage, its own people, would act like this.
It's absolute madness, Tucker. I can't even tell you. For the regular British man or woman in the street, they're just shaking their heads and going, what has this country come to? We're welcoming back the mad mullahs. We're welcoming back the jihadis after they've done their jihad in Iraq or Syria. And by the way, they're not that good at jihad. You know, so you're supposed to blow yourself up if you come back. You probably weren't that great at jihad in the first place.
Good point.
But we are turning away conservatives who just want to stand up for being Christian conservatives. And our Home Office here has sided with the Islamists of Luton. We seem to have some new blasphemy laws here in the UK that we didn't really know about, but are certainly being enforced.
Blasphemy laws that are applied to Christians, but not to Muslims. So what undergirds this? So of course, you know, for centuries, Britain sent forth Anglican missionaries to spread Christianity around the world. And by the way, they did. And now they would not let those same people in their own country in favor of ISIS members. What animates this? Why the change? Why do they feel this way?
There's this pervasive thought that's spread amongst liberals. It's amongst the Labour Party, the Democrats, if you will, and the Conservatives. We have a Conservative government in power. You wouldn't believe it. It seems to be that being white is considered wrong. Being Christian is considered wrong. Trump is wrong. And then there's a list of right answers. To be Islamic is right. To welcome back jihadis is right. We shouldn't prosecute them. We should embrace them. And it's really getting to a point here in the UK where, you know, we're up there on the endangered species list. To be a white Christian conservative woman like myself, I'm right up there on the endangered, you know, animals list, up there with the black rhino. And the black rhino has got an advantage because he's black.
So, I mean, the UK is a democracy, purportedly. You voted for Brexit. You still get to vote there for the time being. The majority of your population, I would bet you my car, does not agree with the policies I just described. Why are they putting up with them?
There's this kind of sense right now, this place, this country has never been this tense. It feels like a pressure cooker, you know, and someone's screwing down the lid. And there's going to be a tipping point. And that feeling of just people going to be rising up to say, right, no more of this. We will not be silenced anymore. And the thing is, people hold on to certain voices. There's a lot of support for these YouTubers that you spoke of that were banned.
Yes.
And when you start silencing the people that were even, you know, finally speaking out for us, people like myself, in fact, I'm surprised I'm still here. I'm surprised I haven't been deported. You know, them people, there will come a point where enough is enough. And I think there will be some kind of uprising, because watching conservatives being detained for 2 days, being charged with kind of, or detained on terror, suspicion of terror offences, when they're just young conservatives with a passion for their culture and a passion for their country, it really is such a disappointing time for the UK.
Yeah.
And I do think there needs to be much more of an attitude where we stop tiptoeing around the cultures that choose to come and join us and start defending the culture they have chosen to join.
It used to be kind of a free country. That's authoritarian, what you're describing. And I'm sorry. Katie, thank you for coming on and telling us about that. It sounded familiar.